Hi, my name is Mylon Lefevre, and music is in my blood. I got my first big break when Elvis Presley recorded a song I'd written at 17 years old. That moment changed my life forever. I went from having nothing to having my dreams come true. I toured the world and played with some of the biggest names in music and had more money than I knew what to do with. I finally hit rock bottom when I almost died from a drug overdose, and it became painfully obvious something had to change. Everything did change when I gave my life to Jesus at a Second Chapter of Acts concert in 1980. God instantly delivered me from drugs and totally turned my life around. I began to use my gift of music for the Lord and started a Christian band, Mylon and Broken Heart. It eventually grew to be one of the biggest Christian rock bands in the world at the time. We won several Grammys and Dove Awards, but most importantly, we led over 200,000 kids to Christ. Now, years later, I'm still living for Jesus, and my wife, Christy, and I travel the globe proclaiming God's goodness. I've been from rock bottom to the mountaintop, and I'm going all the way to heaven. So come on and join me on the road to freedom.
Mylon Lefevre, and this is my wife, Christy Lefevre, and this is On the Road to Freedom. Welcome today. We're going to have so much fun. You know, John 8:31, Jesus said, "If you continue in my word, you will be my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free." That's why we call this show On the Road to Freedom. Today, we're in Colorado. Look at this magnificent
view.
Oh, my Lord. We've been skiing some lately, and Matthew's been out climbing waterfalls that are frozen. I mean, we've been in the snow. We've fallen into creeks. All kind of funny stuff has happened. Thank God these angels take care of us. Anyway, we got out here and got set up, and then we found out they're doing construction right down here, so you're going to hear some beeping. It's all cool. I like beeping. Beeping's good. And we're going to share the word with you. Christy's got a word for us today, and man, I am so looking forward to hearing it. She's my favorite teacher in the whole world. Come on, girl,
mine.
What you got for us?
Amen. First of all, welcome. Welcome to the show. We're so glad that you tuned in. We're so thankful for you. And we believe today will be a right word for you at the right moment.
Amen.
That's what Proverbs says, and it'll be good to you when you hear it. So I want to start with Psalm 126, 1 through 3. And it says, "When the Lord turned our captivity..." Oh, thank you, Jesus. Another version says, "restored our fortunes and changed our circumstances for the better." Mm. We were like those who dream.
Yes.
Well, we can testify to that one, can't we?
Oh, sweet dreams. Come on.
"Then our mouths were filled with laughter." You know, you hear us laughing a lot. You hear Mylon says, "I giggle a lot." Well, that's a good thing. Laughter is good medicine, isn't
it?
Isn't that
is.
What the word
Amen.
Says? "Our mouths were filled with laughter and our tongues with singing. Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them." So this laughter and this singing was so loud that others heard it and said, "Wow, the Lord has done great things for them."
Then it goes on to say, "The Lord has done great things for us. We are glad," and we are. We're here to proclaim today how thankful and glad we are for what the Lord has done.
Yes,
and the good news is He's not done.
He's not finished.
He's still doing good stuff every day.
It unfolds every day.
For the rest of our lives, and then we get to go to heaven.
Amen.
Woo-hoo-hoo.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
So when Jesus set us free and now made us family in His kingdom, He changed our position from under to over.
Exactly.
And so that's why today I want to encourage you that it's time to get over it. And I'm going to keep going with that and explain in a minute. Ephesians 2, 5 through 6 says that we've been raised up with Christ Jesus and we are seated with Him in heavenly places. Christ has totally defeated the enemy.
Amen.
And all things are under His feet. And because we are seated with Him, then all things are under our feet. That's why we can get over it. We can rise above the circumstance
Amen.
Because we are seated with Christ Jesus. Amen. And you know, I have an example I want to share with you. The way the Lord revealed this to me. You know, Mylon, a few years ago, had been going through some really intense health challenges, and he might want to expound on that. But we came home from the hospital, and we were both fighting discouragement because the negative reports from the doctors, I mean, anything negative, any kind of sickness and disease you could think of, they spoke over him. So we had to say, by faith, we don't receive that. We resist it.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
We resist the devil. My body is God's property.
Yes.
And Satan has no right to be destroying God's property. I'm put on this earth to do the will of God.
Mm-hmm.
I'm filled with the Holy Spirit of the living God, as
That's
the Bible
right.
says all Christians are.
That's right.
Your body is now the temple of the Holy Spirit, the Bible says, if you're mm-hmm. born again, and I am. So that's the way you resist the devil. We had to say out loud.
We had to say
no,
it out
we
loud.
Don't receive those mm-hmm. things. And by the way, praise God, all these years later, I don't have any of those diseases.
That's right, you don't.
Just like Jesus said, by his stripes I was healed, and I still am.
Amen. But
Glory
at this time, I remember coming home that next day, and we had both made those confessions. We were standing together in agreement, but the thoughts and the lies of the enemy kept coming to my mind. You know, the battlefield
yes.
is in the mind.
Yes.
And I kept hearing, what are you going to do? This is bad. What are you going to do?
It was a hard time.
Yes.
And the only mm-hmm. reason we're admitting that to you and testifying that to you is because I know you go through them too.
Right.
We know you go through them too. And there is a way to go through them and come
yes.
out on the other side with victory.
Yes.
There is no place on this earth where you can avoid all trials and tribulations and tests. That's when you get to heaven, mm-hmm. you won't have those. But down here on earth, man, sin entered the earth many, many years ago in the Garden of Eden. And so mm-hmm. there is sickness and disease, and there's all kind of problems. So what Christy is teaching you today is mm-hmm. going to teach you how to get over this situation, go through to the other side, total victory
right.
in Jesus' name.
And so as I was praying in the Spirit over this situation, because I had prayed everything in the natural with my understanding that I could pray, and so as I was praying that out, then the Lord gave me just a word. As I was praying, Mylon was with me. We were in the kitchen, mm-hmm. and I heard myself say, don't ever let yourself get under anything ever again, because I've raised you up in Christ Jesus, and the blessing of the Lord causes you to be above only and never beneath.
Mm-hmm.
So my encouragement to you today, the reason why, you know, we can get over it, we are never to be under pressure. We are never to be under stress, under guilt, or condemnation. Again, in Christ, we can get over it. We can rise above it, because the blessing of the Lord causes us to be above only and never beneath.
Amen.
So that correction from the Lord is, I had allowed myself to get under the pressure of those negative reports. So when I heard that correction, I just made that adjustment. And immediately said, I mean, we started praising God. Thank you, Lord. We are above only. We are never beneath.
Amen.
We are not getting under this. We're rising above it.
This scripture that she quoted about being seated in the heavenly places with
yes,
Jesus.
Yes,
I just want to remind you that the Word says that Jesus is seated at the right hand of the
right.
Father in the place of
all
authority.
Yeah.
This is not just
Ooh,
a nice place
mind.
In heaven.
Yes.
It's the place where when the devil attacks you, you as a believer in Jesus Christ
Yeah.
have authority over him.
Yeah, that's so good, man. Well, hey, Team Mylon. I just want to remind you about our Church on the Run daily digital devotionals. And those are a scripture or two for the day that we have filmed on location in beautiful places all over the planet, like Yosemite Falls, the Grand Canyon, the mountaintop in Banff, Canada, the beach in Maui, lots of beautiful places. And you can take that scripture for the day and meditate on it. We believe, according to Proverbs, that it will be a right word at the right moment, and it'll be good to you when you hear it. But you know, you don't have to take my word for it. Let me tell you what others are saying about Church on the Run. We got this report from Suzette, and she says, thank you for the ministry God has placed you in and for the words you speak. I personally am old in this walk, but found myself in a dark place of no growth. Your short sermons hit home, and I am greatly encouraged. Praise God, Suzette. That's a good report. We also heard from Jake, and he said, woohoo! I like that. I say that all the time. Woohoo! This was just for me today. Thank you, guys. So check out Church on the Run on our website. We're at Milan.org, and we believe that each day it will be a word in due season for you. Be blessed. We love you. First John 5:4, another promise for you being an overcomer. For whatever is born of God overcomes the world. Do you see the analogy here? We're rising above. We're getting over it. Whoever's born of God overcomes the world. This is the victory that has overcome the world, even our faith. Who is the one that overcomes the world? But he who believes that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. So it is time for us to get over it.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So how do we get over it and stay over it? Well, we do that by faith. And, you know, I have another story I'd like to tell you on this one, because this really helped me understand how to press in and stay in faith in every challenge and every circumstance that we come up against in life. And, you know, this may be new to you. I just want to remind you, Jesus said that in this world you will have trials. You will have tribulation.
Yes.
You will have things that come up. That's why it's called the fight of faith. There is a fight to faith. But he said, but be of good cheer, because I have overcome the world. Mm-hmm. I have deprived it of the power to harm you. Mm-hmm. So when you stay in faith, you always win.
Sometimes the devil tries to disguise what the fight is about.
Mm,
you know, the Word of God tells us we're never doing battle against flesh and blood.
Yeah.
People are not the problem.
That's
we're doing
it.
Battle against great powers,
Amen.
Principalities, rulers of darkness in the unseen world.
Yeah.
That's who we're doing battle against.
Mm-hmm.
And who are these? I mean, for instance, if the doctor says you've got cancer, you're not really doing a fight of faith against cancer. What you're doing is a fight of faith against the spirit of fear that comes against you and says, you can pray all you want to, you're not getting healed.
Mm-hmm.
If you're afraid that God is not honest, and if you're afraid of that God's word is not true, then that's the fight of faith. The decision that you have to make to win the fight of faith is, it doesn't matter what 50 doctors say, it doesn't matter what CAT scans, blood tests, those are just facts.
Right.
And we don't deny the facts, but the truth is the Word of God.
Yeah.
Remember the name of this show, if you continue in my word, whatever God says.
Yeah, that's the truth.
You will be my disciple. You will know the truth.
Yes.
And it will make you free from disease, poverty, lack, depression. It'll set you free from anything.
Well, do you remember the time we went to Yellowstone with my parents?
Yes, ma'am.
My mom and dad. And we decided we were going to try snowmobiling for the first time. And so it was a beautiful, beautiful day, beautiful scenery. We're all having fun. And little did I know that, you know, we're going at a slow pace, our own pace. No big deal. We're just having a good time. And little did I know that Mylan had talked to our guide and said, now, as she gets comfortable, as Christy gets comfortable, you can speed up at the end and kind of take some hills and we'll
get
have
some
fun,
air.
Get some air. I didn't know this. So on the way home, we encountered this hill that the guide goes, okay, we're going over that hill. Once we get over it, we're on our way home. And I looked at it.
We were in a canyon.
Yeah.
It was the only way out. The guy had taken this way.
It was the only way out.
And it was the only way to get out of this area that we had gone into. And you had to get to rocking to get up.
But it was the incline.
It was straight up.
It was straight up.
Yeah.
And I looked at it, and I looked at him, and I said, I'm not doing it. I said, I will go around. I am not doing it. And the guide said, the sun is setting. We have no choice. You have to go up the incline. And Mylan said, Christy, you can do it. I'll go first. So Mylan did it. He did great, of course. He loved the adventure of it. Well, then my mom, who's with me, she looks at me, and my mom is about 5'2", petite, but she sees that I'm scared. So her mama bear kicks in, and she looks at me and she said, Christy, I've been watching you. And all day when you get scared, you're backing off of the gas. And she said, the only way that you're going to get up that hill is to keep the gas on the whole time.
Wide open.
Because you're going to have to go wide open, because if you back off of the gas, you're going to stall or it's going to fall back. And she said, now watch me. And she took off and she cleared that hill and did great. And
it was awesome.
Turned around, looked at me and said, come on. And so I thought, well, my goodness, I cannot let my little mama outdo me. And so I took off. I kept the gas on, and praise God, I cleared it. And then, of course, my dad, he's last, and he sees I am not, you know, he decides I'm not going to let my wife and my daughter outdo me, so he really goes for it.
Oh, Lord, he looked like the X Games, man. It was ridiculous. He was rocking.
He cleared so much air.
He got about 15 feet of air on the top of that baby. I didn't know if he could. I didn't think he could land it.
I didn't think he could.
It was awesome.
Yeah, he did great. So after that happened, the Lord just ministered something to me, and there's going to be challenges in life that if we're going to get over that challenge and that circumstance, we're going to have to keep faith on.
Amen.
The whole time. In order for you to be an overcomer in Him, you're going to have to stay wide open when it comes to your faith.
That's right.
Because if you stall, if you draw back in fear, it'll cause you to lose momentum. And the Word says that we are not of those who draw back. Fear draws back, but faith will always move you forward.
That's right.
And again, Hebrews, it's in Hebrews 10, 35 and 39, and it says, we are not of those who draw back, but we are of those who believe. So
Amen.
I encourage you today, whatever you're facing, keep faith on. Keep it wide open. Mm. Full throttle. Full throttle, you know, faith. That's
amen.
It.
Amen. One scripture says, we press on toward the mark of the high calling.
Yes, yes.
Man, God's got
that's
some
it.
Stuff in your future that's so high and so important and so big and so good, and you're the one that He's anointed and called to do that one thing.
Yeah.
And whatever it is, what Christy's anointed to do, mm-hmm. I can't do.
Yes.
What I'm anointed to do, you can't do. But boy, yeah. what you're anointed to do, nobody can do that better than you.
Yeah.
Man, God has got His super on your natural. So, and you find out exactly what the plan and purpose of will of God is for your life, you're going to find out the grace of God is on you to accomplish
yeah,
that.
Yeah, that's right.
And you don't want to miss that, so keep pressing. That's what we're using our faith for.
That's right.
Pressing on
pressing
toward
on.
The high calling. Praise
Amen.
God. Because of what Christ Jesus has done for us.
So in this situation, I'm applying it all to when we were facing these challenges with Mylon's health, and praise God, he overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of His testimony.
Amen.
And we are walking in that victory today, and we're thankful and give God all the glory for it. In rising above that circumstance and making the commitment to stay in faith, to keep our faith on, one day again in prayer, you know I'm giving you a bunch of stories today, but again, Satan is defeated by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. So we're testifying to you today that we have faced the same challenges. And when we applied the word works.
Amen.
It works every time. It never fails. And so in this situation, again, I was up in prayer one day, and I was just thinking about how these challenges through the years had really just stole such our time, our money, you know, going to hospitals, surgeries, doctor's appointments, medicines, our momentum. We'd get going real good in God, and then boom, He'd be facing something and we'd lose momentum. We'd lose time.
That's right.
Youth, His years being stolen from.
Sure. You're doing everything you know to do, and you're wondering, why is it, you know, is it my faith?
Right.
Am I lacking in faith?
Wrong?
Am I doing
yeah.
something wrong?
Yeah.
And the bottom line is, no, there's a devil that hates you.
Mm-hmm.
And he's trying to kill you. There's a thief that comes to steal and kill and destroy.
Yes.
And he hates you. And the more that you do for God, the more that he'll do anything. If he can't get you to go back into sin, I mean, he can't tempt me to start taking heroin again or running around on her, do something, rob a bank or shoot somebody. What he tries to do is knock my focus off.
Mm-hmm.
He tries to attack my child or my marriage or anything he can, my
right.
health, my finances, anything he can to stop me and limit me from doing all that God's called me to do with a good attitude.
Right.
Well, we just had to get over it, didn't we, baby?
Yeah, we did. We did. So I found that in this time of challenge again, as I was praying, the Holy Spirit just interrupted my thought life and said, why don't you ask me to restore to you what's been stolen? Because
yes.
I'm ready.
Yeah.
I'm ready to restore. And immediately I was reminded, James says, you have not because you ask not. And then there's a scripture in Isaiah 42:22 that confirms this. And I understood why again, the Holy Spirit. Now, let me say this. If this is new for you, it was not an audible voice. It was the Holy Spirit. It's in.
It's a prompting.
It's a prompting.
Inside. It's
right.
A,
it's a still small
it's a leading,
voice.
Yeah.
Right. In Isaiah 42:22, it confirms this, saying, "But this is a people, my people, have been robbed from, they've been plundered, they have become a prey with no one to deliver them because they have no one to say, restore them."
Yeah, amen.
And I understood then why the Holy Spirit was saying, "Why don't you ask me? Because I'm ready." All these things you're frustrated about that you realize you've been stolen from, the enemy is the thief. He's the one that comes to steal, kill, and destroy. And you've recognized that you've been stolen from. So why don't you ask me to restore you?
Thank
because
you,
I'm
Lord.
Ready. And praise God, when He restores you, He didn't just restore you to original state.
That's right.
It says if the thief is found out, he must restore seven times what's been stolen. Praise God. So that's seven times the health, seven times the youth, the years, the dreams being fulfilled.
Because
what I realized
the finances,
is
yeah.
energy and the finances. What I realized is we were just getting through the day. We were not laughing anymore. We definitely weren't dreaming. We were just dealing with what was right
Survival
in front of us. Right.
Is not abundant laugh in Christ.
No,
and that's
not
what Jesus came to give us.
Yes.
Abundant laugh. And we have to press in and get mm-hmm. it. And praise God, we have a part in the restoration.
Yes, we do.
And our part is to believe for it.
Yes.
And
to say, restore us, Lord.
Yes.
And so when I saw that, I went down to Him and immediately and shared with Him what I believed the Lord had given me. And we both joined hands and got an agreement. Husbands and wives, this is so important for you to do together. And if you're not married, just find someone to get in agreement with you, a faith-filled
Amen.
Friend,
Amen.
One of like precious faith. And Mylon and I got agreement, and we said, "Lord, we recognize now that we've been stolen from."
That's right.
And so we declare, "Restore us, Lord." And we're believing for
Thank
seven
you,
times what's been stolen. Seven times our joy, our laughter,
yes.
the finances, the time, the youth, we're declaring seven times. And immediately when we began to say that, "Restore us, Lord," our situation began to turn. And God just started unfolding that restoration to us day by day. It was supernatural.
It was, baby. I'm reminded that Joel, God promises us, "I will restore to you the years
yes,
that the swarming locust, meaning our sin,
yeah.
our bad choices,
He'll
has eaten."
Years.
God said, "I'll give you back the years that sin took out of
yeah.
your life." Now,
yeah.
for me, that was a lot of years. And the reason I'm sharing this, baby,
yeah,
is
so good,
we were talking about my health, and
yeah.
and I did take a lot of drugs, and I did smoke, and I did a lot of things and drink that were bad for my body. When I had my heart attack, I was 48 years old, and they gave me this report that I was going to do all these, you know, that I shouldn't leave the country, I should get off the road, I shouldn't be able to travel. I had a bus at the time. We were flying when we couldn't get our bus and truck there in time. I mean, we were doing a lot of things that they said I could never do again,
mm-hmm.
and I was 48. I'm 73 now, and
yeah,
we just
hallelujah.
Rolled up 2 million miles on
Yeah.
American just in the last 20 years.
Yes.
I have been millions of miles since they said, yeah. "You can't do this anymore."
Woo.
And I have done
Praise
exactly
God.
What God told me
God.
For a lot of years.
Yes.
And the good news is God restored the years.
He restored
the cankerworm, our sin took away. Glory
That's right.
to God.
And if you need your joy restored today, Psalm 51:12 says, "Restore to me the joy of thy salvation."
Ooh, come
Amen.
On, honey.
"And renew a right spirit within me."
Amen.
Hallelujah. When you feel weak, your youth is renewed like the eagle. That's
Amen.
Restoration.
Exactly.
In Jeremiah 30:17, it says that He will restore health to us and heal all our wounds for healing, for wholeness. If you have lost relationships over your commitment to the Lord, then Mark 10:29-30 says that whatever you lost for the gospel's sake, that we will receive 100 times as much in this life. Amen. So
Thank
those are
you,
all
Lord.
Promises of restoration. And whatever you're dealing with today, I encourage you to look in the Word, find those promises that apply to your situation, and begin to declare, "Restore me, Lord."
I just love this word. It says, "Restore to me the joy of your salvation
yeah.
and make me willing to obey you." That's
oh,
what it means
good.
To set within me a right spirit,
mm-hmm.
A right attitude. There's been times, I'm just being I'm testifying and I'm making confession, and I'm not proud of this. I'm actually ashamed of it, but it's time to be honest with you. There's times in my Christian walk in the last 38 years where it got dry and it got so hard, and she admitted to you, and you're in survival mode and you're just doing battle and you're holding on, having done all this to stand, you're standing.
Yeah.
But you get in a dry place and you get weary in well doing, and your integrity, you're holding up, you're doing what you know to do, but you just get tired and you want to react in the flesh, and you want to get angry and you want to get frustrated and you want to vent and you want to do and say the wrong things, and you get in a dry place with God. And so I'm just being honest with you. It's good to know that God did this for King David when he sinned. He set within him a right spirit. He renewed his strength. He renewed his youth. He restored his soul. He laid him down beside the still waters.
Yeah.
And he just refreshed.
Restore my soul. That's good. Your mind, your will, and emotions. There's another good restoration promise. The Lord is our shepherd, and he restores our soul. Amen. That's good.
You going to pray over my love?
Sure.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Well, if you'll join your faith with us, please, we want to agree with you for total restoration.
Yes.
And Lord, Mylon and I do that right now. We agree with those who are watching for total restoration of all things stolen.
Thank you, my Master.
Lord, we're believing for seven times in their life.
Lord.
If it's health, if it's restoration of relationships, if it's youth, if it's joy and laughter, if it's dreams being fulfilled, we join our faith with them for seven times what's been stolen.
Yes, my
And we believe that from this day forward, that they experience your goodness at a level that they've never known before. I ask you, Lord, just to overtake them with your blessing.
Bless them, Lord.
And again, Lord, we thank you for your goodness to us.
Spirit.
And I thank you that in Christ Jesus, we are overcomers. Mm. We're rising above every situation, every challenge, and every circumstance by our faith
in you.
We're getting over it.
Thank you,
We're
Lord.
Above it, because we are seated with you in
Lord.
Heavenly places.
Thank you, God.
So I praise you, Father, for proving again today how much you love them.
Thank you, Lord.
And how good you are.
Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. So just be encouraged today and stay in the Word, and that'll keep you on the road to freedom.
Get over it. In this teaching, you'll learn to rise above every challenge, receive your total restoration, and get your hopes up. Go to Mylon.org to order your copy today.